Hey guys, it's Prince Rich with Rich Technology Group. And in today's video, the video is actually called Does 911 Work on a Voice over IP Phone System? Does 911 Work on a VoIP Phone System? This is a question that I've actually been asked by many, many customers that have called me from all around the United States that are looking to switch from a traditional phone system or from traditional analog lines or what we call POTS lines. Where 911 works because the copper line is in the ground and it goes back to the CO or back to the carrier. So when you dial 911, they know where you are. As many of you may or may not know, Voice over IP has the ability for you to have phones not only within your local city, but anywhere for remote staff or employees via a mobile app, whatever it may be. So the question that everybody asks me, especially when it comes to certain types of businesses that we work with, such as things like retail stores or supermarkets, daycare centers, doctor's offices, schools, things like that, where 911 is a big deal, and not being able to dial 911 could not only be a liability, but could cause potential problems with person's safety. We get asked this question a lot. So I'm gonna run down the rundown of how 911 works differently with voice over IP phone systems. And how you can ensure that when you do need to dial 911 with your voice over IP phone system, it will not only work, but the authorities will be able to track your location were something to happen and you weren't able to relay it to them before the call got disconnected or whatever. So anyways, the first thing is, does 911 work with a voice over IP phone system? In short, yes, but there are some catches and there are some things that you need to know and that you need to consider when setting up your phone system. We're going to go over these things now. So, as I mentioned before, in order for a voice over IP phone system has the ability for you to essentially be anywhere. I'll give you an example. At one point within our company, we not only had, we still do have an administrative assistant, but we also have technicians in Virginia. But I also at one point had salespersons that were working all throughout the United States as well as all throughout the world. I had a couple that were actually living overseas. That had IP phones that we had given to them on the company system that had their own extension. And so the question became, does 911 work? Now you have to understand with a setup like that, where let's say my extension's in Virginia, then in Richmond, Virginia, and then I had a person whose extension is in Midlothian, Virginia, and then somebody who's in like the Forest Hill Avenue, Virginia area, and then somebody in Costa Rica, and then somebody in California. And then somebody in Ohio, obviously for the company, 911 can't be all on the same main address, which for the company is a Richmond, Virginia address. It has to be spread out. Basically, what this boils down to is when you set up your voice over IP system initially, for each individual phone that is not in the main location. So let's back that up. When you set up voice over IP with a provider, it doesn't matter which provider, but when you set it up, you have a main billing address. So let's just say, for the sake of conversation, that main billing address is 11111, Sesame Street, Richmond, Virginia. That means that by default, if you were to dial 911 from any of the phones on the system, let's say it's 20 phones, that's going to default to the authorities and be default coded or traced to that 1111 Sesame Street, Richmond, Virginia address. Now, if you're like my company, which a lot of companies are, where you've got other people that may be working out of their home or working out of state or working out of country with an IP phone, here is how this works. Every single phone that is not set on that main address or doesn't reside at that main address, you need to actually go inside of the system and you have to actually tell the system what that phone's address is. Most voice over IP phone systems will literally have a thing in it that says for each individual extension or each person's phone, we'll call it users, extensions, whatever you want to call it. It will have a thing that says 911 information. And it will specifically state something to the letter of if the address or location of the person that is using this phone or extension is different from the main billing address of the company, please specify it here. That's where that person would specify, okay, my address where this phone resides is, 2000 Walnut Avenue, New York, New York, or something like that, whatever it may be. The short of it is you need to understand that your main billing address, is basically going to be what the default company was set up as, which is typically, for most of you watching this that have multiple locations or multiple people using a phone, that's going to be like your main headquarters or something like that. So you have to go into the system and you have to specify what the address where that extension resides is. Let's throw out another example out there for those of you watching so that this makes sense and you understand exactly how you need to set this up. So let's say that you've got two locations. One location has 10 voice over IP phones, we'll say through Nextiva. And then the other location has 10 IP phones through Nextiva. One location is in Richmond, Virginia. The other location, we'll say, is in High Point, North Carolina. If the main location that you set the account up on is the Richmond, Virginia location, then you need to specify in the system that the 10 phones at the High Point, North Carolina location, that those are on the High Point, North Carolina address. By doing this, you basically told the service provider that in the event that 911 gets called, it knows which ones are at which location. So I hope that makes sense. That's really the short of it is you can't assume, if you're going to be scattering phones throughout your company, don't assume that 911 is going to know how to route and know how to work. You need to get with your service provider and tell them, hey, you know, I watched this video on YouTube and I've realized that I've got to specify what my 911 location is for the individual users or for the individual sets of phones at individual locations. If you're watching this and you're not tech savvy and or you don't have the time to deal with this, it's no big deal. Most all of the providers, because this is not only a liability for you, it could be a liability for them. Most all of the providers have a customer service or technical support team that will log into your account with you on the phone and say, hey, can you give me the address information for the different phones or extensions or different groups of phones? And they'll set this for you and they'll double check it with you and make sure that it's set correctly. So that is really the short of how you need to set up your phone system so that 911 works. It can be done on any platform and any voice over IP service provider, but understand that at the end of the day, it's your responsibility to get with the service provider and make sure that that is set up the way it's supposed to be. So if any of you have any questions about this, feel free to comment on the video or drop me an email with any questions you've got. Again, all of the service providers allow this function and they will help you set this up. Again, if you have any questions, doors open. But the short of it is yes, 911 will work on a voice over IP phone system. But if your phone system has multiple phones or users outside of the main location or main billing address, you have to set that up on your own. So again, Prince Rich with Rich Technology Group, your go-to guy for the best deals on business phone and internet service in the United States. Thanks for watching the video. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel, and I'll catch you guys again in the next video.